poet Rudyard Kipling was born on December 30, 1865 in Bombay, India. He was educated in England but returned to India in 1882. A decade later, decade means 10 years. After 10 years, Kipling married Caroline Ballister and settled in Brattleboro, Vermont, where he wrote The Jungle Book in 1894. Among a host of other works that made him hugely successful, Kipling was the recipient of the 1907 Nobel Prize in Literature, and he died in 1936. See the main theme of the poem and this chart. This poem symbolizes means represents that machines also have secrets. The poem deals with the problem of modern technology and automation. The beginning, the reader gets informed about how machines are produced and what kind of treatment they need. Afterwards, the machines explain how they can serve humanity. The poem ends with the statement that machines, although capable of great deeds, are still nothing more than creations of the human brain. The poet qualifies machine to define the situation from their point of view. Let me read the poem. We were taken from the ore bed and the mine. We were melted in the furnace and the pit. We were cast and wrought and hammered to design. We were cut and filed and tooled and gassed to fit. The meaning of the first stanza is, we were dug out as ores from mines. Then we were melted in the furnace. Furnace means a highly heated oven to melt ores in large quantity. And the pit. Afterwards, we were cast, wrought, hammered, cut, and filed to shape, and tooled and hassed to fit. The first stanza is stated about how did machines come to life. Some important words in the second stanza. Some water, coal, and oil is all we ask, and a thousandth of an inch to give us play. And now, if you will set us to our task, we will serve you 24 hours a day. Which means, machines demand fuel such as water, coal, oil for their performance. Machines do not need break. Machines need little place to work. With all these, if people set us to work, the machines will work 24 hours for us. Third stanza. We can pull and haul and push and lift and drive. We can print and plow and weave and heat and light. We can run and race and swim and fly and dive. We can see and hear and count and read and write. The stanza represents a number of varied machinery in terms of the task they do. The machine say that they can pull, haul, push, lift, drive, print, plow, weave, heat, light, etc., etc. In these lines, machines tell what they can do. But remember, please, the law by which we live, we are not built to comprehend a lie. We can neither love nor pity nor forgive. If you make a slip in handling us, you die. The laws that rule machines set them different from humans. What are these differences? It is true that machines can do more work than human beings, but a machine is essentially different from a human being. While man is able to tell lies, machine cannot detect one, nor can it perform dishonestly. Besides, a machine is not fitted to love or hate its owner or anyone. A motor bus cannot feel pity when it runs over a bunch of children, nor can it forgive the driver who failed to fill its fuel tanks in time. Moreover, machines are not able to compromise in the face of lie and dishonesty. Though our smoke may hide the heavens from your eyes, it will vanish and the stars will shine again, because for all our power and weight and size, we are nothing more than children of your brain. The masons say the smoke produced by us may hide the sky from people's eye, but the smoke will vanish soon and people can see the stars again. Though we have a lot of power and strength and size, we, the machines, are only the children of human brain.